Hello, this is Monster Man Dan, welcoming all Super 8 film collectors to the presentation of the Ghidrah Super 8 two-part digest edit. Being a monster kid from the 60s, I grew up with a passion and love for classic movie monsters. Watching those horror and science fiction movies on television, building the Aurora monster model kits, and collecting 8mm silent 200-foot digests became many a kid's dream during the nation's monster craze of the 60s. Yes, Godzilla movies were a big favorite. These two Super 8 silent black and white Ken Films digests are released from the 1965 movie Ghidrah, the Three-Headed Monster. Saw the film ads many a times in the back pages of Famous Monsters of Filmland magazine. At about age 16, I remember purchasing these at a nearby Nichols Discount City store. Got both at the same time and enjoyed these separately for quite a while. Then I entertained the thought of splicing these 200-foot excerpts together into a 400-foot version. Wanted to show you how I pieced this all together. The film reels were processed with a squeezed image and needed the aid of a scope lens to stretch out the picture to widescreen proportions. Unfortunately, I didn't have a scope lens in the 60s, but obtained one years later. After the splice and re-edit job, I took scissors to both boxes and did a cut-and-paste job, along with the highlighting of some colored magic markers and extras, to produce a custom 400-foot housing using a reel-to-reel tape recording cardboard box. The first 400-foot film I ever had at age 16. The ultimate viewing of this film is with projector and screen. You can see my amateur transfer setup lacks in the image being pin sharp, and I'm always battling with film projector flicker and hotspots. How I edited the two digests together basically is the idea here. Film footage used from either Ghidrah, the Three-Headed Monster, or from Ghidrah Battles will be indicated at the lower left part of the screen. I strictly collected and viewed 200-foot silent digests all during the 60s, and it really never bothered me enjoying them at 18 frames a second. So this edit will be seen at 18 frames a second, the way I enjoyed the film showings in my upstairs bedroom cinema, with just the glorious sound of a running projector. Yes, the love of classic monsters has been passed down through our family. If you ask my monster-loving 3-year-old granddaughter, Peyton Blair, "Hey Peyton, who is your favorite all-time big monster?"
"Godzilla!" Hey, Peyton, who is your favorite all-time big monster?